If it weren't for compromised ethics, some politicians would have no ethics at all. Viva Frei, Montreal litigator turned YouTuber, and this is Winnie the Westie, and it seems Press Secretary Jen Psaki has found herself in a little bit of hot water for some statements she made about a week or two ago, and it seems that she might have violated something known as the Hatch Act. The Hatch Act, for those of you who may not know, I am taking a wild guess, was named after someone named Hatch. The Hatch Act of 1939, an act to prevent pernicious political activities, is a United States federal law. Its main provision prohibits civil service employees in the executive branch of the federal government, except the president and vice president, from engaging in some forms of political activity. It became law on August 2, 1939. The law was named for Senator Carl Hatch of New Mexico. It was most recently amended in 2012. I totally legit predicted that the law was named after someone named Hatch, although I guess that really isn't that much of an educated guess that I should feel smart about, but the law seems to apply only to civil service employees and not to the president and vice president themselves, and that's going to be relevant for something Kamala Harris said, and we'll get to that a little later in this vlog. For now, let's just see exactly what Jen Psaki said that landed her in hot water.
I have to be a little careful about how much political analysis I do from here and not traipse into that too much. Look, I think the president, of course, wants former Governor McAuliffe to be the future governor of Virginia. There is alignment on a lot of their agenda, whether it is the need to invest in rebuilding our roads, rails, and bridges, or making it easier for women to rejoin the workforce. We're going to do everything we can to help former Governor McAuliffe, and we believe in the agenda he's representing.
All right, so now you have heard what Jen Psaki said from the podium in her capacity as press secretary for the President of the United States, but I think we need to delve into a little bit of the context, the background of how that law came to be law. Background: widespread allegations that local Democratic Party politicians used employees of the Works Progress Administration, WPA, during the congressional elections of 1938 provided the immediate impetus for the passage of the Hatch Act. Criticism centered on swing states such as Kentucky, Tennessee, Pennsylvania, and Maryland. In Pennsylvania, Republicans and dissident Democrats publicized evidence that Democratic politicians were consulted on the appointment of WPA administrators and caseworkers, and that they used WPA jobs to gain unfair political advantage. In 1938, a series of newspaper articles exposed WPA patronage and political contributions in return for employment, prompting an investigation by the Senate Campaign Expenditures Committee, headed by Senator Morris Shepherd, a Texas Democrat. Corruption in Washington, say it ain't so. The more things change, the more they stay the same. And what's really funny about Jen Psaki's alleged violations of the Hatch Act is how the mainstream media reports on it differently depending on the political leanings of whatever agency is reporting on it. Top stories: Fox News, Psaki, I've learned my lesson after Hatch Act complaint. CNBC, Biden press secretary Jen Psaki may have violated ethics law with comment on Virginia, dot dot dot. USA Today, White House press secretary Jen Psaki accused of violating Hatch Act. Well, political spin aside, one thing seems relatively incontrovertible. Jen Psaki probably very well likely violated the terms of the Hatch Act with what she said. And let's read exactly why. Psaki, quote, I've learned my lesson, end quote, after Hatch Act complaint. Psaki faced ethics complaint for endorsing Terry McAuliffe from White House podium. White House press secretary Jen Psaki said she's learned her lesson and will refrain from providing political analysis from the podium after she was accused earlier this month of violating the Hatch Act. Psaki made the comments Tuesday after a reporter asked during her daily press briefing whether President Biden was, quote, surprised, end quote, by how close the gubernatorial race is in Virginia between Democratic nominee Terry McAuliffe, the former Virginia governor, and Republican nominee Glenn Youngkin. Now, what's particularly funny about Jen Psaki's apology is that she says she has learned her lesson and will refrain from providing political commentary while speaking from the podium. The funny thing is, that's how she prefaced the answer before she gave the answer.
I have to be a little careful about how much political analysis I do from here and not traipse into that too much.
In her response, Jen Psaki almost quite literally said, I better be careful giving too much political commentary, and then she went on to give the political commentary, so one might come to the conclusion that she knew what the Hatch Act was, she knew of its provisions before violating them from the White House podium. Sorry, before allegedly violating them from the White House podium. Quote, I've learned my lesson, end quote, Psaki responded. Quote, I'm not going to do politics from here or political analysis.
I have to be a little careful about how much political analysis I do from here and not traipse into that too much.
I can confirm that the president is going to Arlington later this evening, and that is my hometown as well. And, of course, the vice president is campaigning there as well. I mean, politics is politics, and we all know the political desires of the people in power based on partisan lines, but even in her apology, even in admitting that she made a mistake, she still goes on to explain how the vice president and the president are in Arlington campaigning for this individual who was running for office. So to some, that apology might not be an apology at all, and it might just be tracking that poop around the house that she has just stepped in, because in her apology, she seems to go on and again implicitly campaign for McAuliffe. Psaki promised earlier this month to choose her words more carefully after Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, CREW, filed a complaint accusing her of violating the Hatch Act, which forbids officials from using their, quote, official authority or influence for the purposes of interfering with or affecting the result of an election, end quote. Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, I'll take.
What are things that do not exist for 800, Alex?
And what is this CREW of which you speak? I had never heard of this entity before, and I was wondering if it was in fact a partisan entity. It seems to be a partisan entity, but a surprising partisan entity. Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington. From Wikipedia, the free encyclopedia. Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, CREW, is a nonprofit 501c3 and nonpartisan U.S. government ethics and accountability watchdog organization. Founded in 2003 as a counterweight to conservative government watchdog groups such as Judicial Watch, CREW works to expose ethics violations and corruption by government officials and institutions and to reduce the role of money in politics. Now, I often, and rightly I dare say, get not some flack, but some comments that I should not rely on Wikipedia because it's a notoriously partisan source, and I tend to agree with that because even in this description, Wikipedia refers to CREW as nonpartisan in the same paragraph that says it was established as a counterweight to conservative watchdogs like Judicial Watch. Either way, I will give CREW the benefit of the doubt because even if they might not be totally nonpartisan, nobody really can be. They went after Donald Trump in the early stages of his presidency. At the very least, they are holding the Biden administration to task for their purported violations in having gone after Psaki. Now, the Hatch Act does in fact provide some relatively serious sanctions for violations, such as removal from federal service or reduction of grade, apparently for a period not to exceed 5 years, but it's just what Jen Psaki said that led to this complaint that puts other things that she said in perspective.
We have the highest ethical standards of any administration in history. A number of ethics officials have conveyed that, and we're proud of that. We have also staffed up at an unprecedented pace, and this is the most diverse administration in American history. So we certainly expect that everyone will abide by those high ethics standards. That applies in how we operate. It also applies in how hiring is done.
That's right. You heard it straight from the mouth of the press secretary for the administration that the administration itself is the most ethical administration in the history of America.
The highest ethical standards of any administration in history.
I have so many memes to insert right now to illustrate exactly what I'm thinking, but I'm just going to go to a classic.
What you just said is one of the most insanely idiotic things I have ever heard. Everyone in this room is now dumber for having listened to it. I award you no points, and may God have mercy on your soul.
As we mentioned previously in this vlog, the Hatch Act does not apply to the president or the vice president themselves, which might explain how Kamala Harris got away with saying what she said, but apparently she may have violated other laws.
We were taught that it was our sacred responsibility to raise our voice and lift up the voices of our community. One of the most significant ways I believe that we can each use our voice is through our vote. So Virginians, you have the opportunity now to raise your voice through your vote, because it's election time. I believe that my friend Terry McAuliffe is the leader Virginia needs at this moment.
I think Kamala Harris is actually in the deepest yogurt. I think that could be a real issue for her. There are ways of appealing to voters other than violating ethics and federal IRS laws.
Yup, it's just par for the course for the most ethical administration in the history of the world, and I'm losing light already at 5 o'clock because winter is descending on Montreal, and winter, when it comes here, it gets dark really early, so I better end this vlog. If you like my videos, you like my content, please be sure to like, share, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and drop a comment in the comment section below because it feeds the algorithm.
In the face! In the face!
No!
If you want to support the channel, all of these support links are in the pinned comment. Robert Barnes and I do weekly streams every Sunday. We do weekly streams with a guest every Wednesday called The Sidebar. You can also find us and support us on Locals at
VivaBarnesLaw.locals.com.
All of my stuff is also on Rumble, so you can find us there. And by the way, the news of the day, Rumble just acquired Locals, so expect live streaming to be fully integrated on Locals very soon, which is great news. But more important than any of that, take care of yourselves. Check in on friends and family. Make sure everyone around you is doing well. And now you know your Vlawg. Peace out. Booyah!